Hello YouTube, it's emac2299. Today I'll be doing a video on few important tweaks that are available in Cydia and has been tested on 3.1.2 and 3.1.3. I'm pretty sure there are many other useful tweaks or applications available in Cydia, but I've just picked out few of them through which I assume that these are the important ones and every iPhone and iPod users should have those on their devices. Okay, so let's go through it. Before going through a review on these applications, I'm just going to tell you that these are the two sources that you're going to add into your Cydia: sinfuliphonerepo.com and repo.beyouriphone.com. If you add these sources, then these applications, you can download them totally free. Otherwise, you'll be paying for them $1.99 or a 99 cents price on it. So let's go through it real quick, guys. Before we install, before we go through it, I'm just going to go through the first one, the installation process of the first one. Every user, I'm pretty sure that they know it. Just for the heck of it, I'm going to go through it. This is an iPhone jailbroken, running on 3.1.2 at the moment, and this has also been tested on 3.1.3, by the way. Open up Cydia and go to that source that I told you before, beyouriphone.com. It's right here. Okay, as you can see, scroll through. Let's see if I want to install Insomnia. Okay, Insomnia Pro. It will be right up here. Here it is, Insomnia Pro on the screen. Go ahead and click on it and modify. Mine says modify, but yours will say install because I've already installed it. So go ahead and install it, confirm it, and that's it. You'll be all set. When Insomnia Pro is installed, you will see an icon on your home screen like that, and it is right up here, Insomnia Pro. What is Insomnia Pro? Just going to the time doesn't allow me that much to go in detail, but I'm trying to do as best as possible, trying to make it easy. Insomnia Pro is a program through which that enables you to connect to your Wi-Fi and keep connected, meaning that it doesn't break your Wi-Fi once connected, and it strengthens it. Even if you restart your iPhone or iPod, it still gets connected to the last recognized wireless connection, and it stays connected. It doesn't break up. So just after installing, enable it, and that's about it. The second one on the screen is Snappy's. What is Snappy? Snappy is a photo application through which you can snap photos right from your lock screen. As you can see, here it is, the lock screen, or anywhere from or within an app or something. You don't even have to go to your photos or camera option and go ahead. Let's say, for example, I'm on my lock background, and I double click my home button, and the camera appears just by double clicking. Just by single clicking, once the camera goes out, if I'm here, just double click on it, and that's about it. This is Snappy. You have to enable Snappy by going into its settings, and you will see it. Snappy comes with Activator, another important tweak. Lockinfo is the third one in my list. Lockinfo is an application that enables you to browse through your main things like mails, calendar, missed calls, voicemails right from your lock background. You don't even have to go inside your iPhone, and you can just see everything that you can do inside. You can actually do it from your outside lock background thing screen. Even I can check my mails right from here, and I have an option of deleting them as well. My Twitter and notifications and weather, and that's about it. So what's the fourth one? I believe, yes, it is Screen Recorder. This is right here, Screen Recorder. After downloading it from Cydia, you will have an icon, Screen Recorder, a red color button. What is a Screen Recorder? Pardon me, guys, this is my mail. Okay, so what is a Screen Recorder? A Screen Recorder is an application that actually records short clips of whatever action you make on your iPhone. Let's give a demo of it. It open Screen Recorder capture, and it shows a countdown. And now it says that video is now being captured. Press the home button. Any application you go into, let's say if I'm into clock or any actions actually you are doing onto your iPhone or iPod will be recorded by Screen Recorder. So I'm just going to go through it real quick and go back to Screen Recorder, stop it. It says some instructions. It is always wise to read the instructions before trying any applications. And it says view and delete. So here it is, my video that it made. Here it is. Okay, this is what I was doing while I was explaining you the demo on Screen Recorder. So this is a short little video that it made. It's useful for little presentations or little quick videos and post them on the YouTube if you don't have your laptop or something. Anyways, so this was a Screen Recorder. Next on my list is Infiniboard, right here, Infiniboard. Okay, what is Infiniboard? Allows you to scroll your icons in a vertical fashion. You can see that my icons are able to be scrolled up and down. You see that this is vertical. This you can enable it after installing Infiniboard. Infinidock, 99.9% of all users know this already. What is Infinidock? This enables your dock to be scrolled in a horizontal fashion, as you can see right up here. This is my dock, and I'm scrolling it. Excuse me. And I'm scrolling it in a horizontal fashion. This what in comes after you install Infinidock. iNoRotate is my next one, next in the list. iNoRotate. Okay, iNoRotate is a very useful application that locks your rotate gesture on different applications. Just a heads up, all these applications when you install will go automatically into your settings, and you can find them right here underneath the store options inside your settings, like Infiniboard, Infinidock, Shrink. I was talking about iNoRotate. Here it is. Enabling all these applications will enable the lock on rotation. So basically I have enabled a lock on SMS and Safari. So what I'm doing is if I open up my SMS and I do it like this, it is not going to rotate. So that's what is a useful tweak for some users that like that. All right, so the next over is in AndroidLock in my list. AndroidLock is also another useful application. I'm just going to go through it for this one real quick on my iPod. When you install AndroidLock, it is going to go into your settings, and this is what it will look like. You have to enable it and change pattern, and you have to enable a pattern like whatever drawing you do. Let's see, if I draw like that, this was my old pattern, and it's asked me again to draw the new pattern. Okay, and redraw it. So you have to be very, very careful using this application, because if you forget the pattern, you will be locked. Then you might end up in restoring your iPhone or iPod, and nobody wants that, of course. So here it is. Now I'm trying to access my iPod. It's not going to let me in until I draw the same pattern that I drew earlier. Okay, I think I drew it like that. And here it is, I'm in. So I'm just going to enable off. All right, and this was the AndroidLock. The next one over in my list was Shrink. What is Shrink? Another useful tweak or application that enables your springboard icons to reduce their sizes. Let's go through it. As I said, these applications will go automatically into your settings options. And here it is, Shrink. My icon size currently is on 100%. If I go through it and make it 50%, let's say, let's go back in it and respring, and boom, that is it. Now you will see my springboard icons will be 50% reduced by the regular size, as you can see now on the screen. Here it is. So just a quick little thought about these applications. Just want to review them. I'm pretty sure, as I said, there are many, many other applications, useful applications available in Cydia to download. And you can go ahead and install them. Just before I end my video, just a little question that I was asked about Skype, that how you can run Skype in your background. Open up Skype, and you have to have background or application installed from Cydia. If I have opened up my Skype, this is my Skype, and if I want to run Skype on my background, so I'm just going to hold the home button and you will see it says background enabled. So when that is enabled, it means the Skype is still running on in your background. It is not off, and you can do whatever else you want to do. So as you can see right up here, my Skype is still on, and if I want to disable that backgrounder, if I don't want Skype to run in my background, I'm just going to hold this again, and my Skype is going to be disabled. Now if I want to log into my Skype account, it is going to take some time, and then it's going to log into it. See that? So that was pretty much the some of the few quick applications that I wanted to discuss. Thank you very much, guys, for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll keep you guys updated. Bye bye.